as the night. As far as I can see. I'm not too sure where we are, my friend. The surface of this ground quite peculiar. I think it is safe to say that we are not in the Shire anymore. No. I believe we are. What's that word? Yes. Believe we are navigationally impaired for the moment. I am a fool of a wizard to have gotten us lost. I am an embarrassment to the Istari. I do hope Saruman does not find out about this. Or any of the Maya, for that matter. They would... I would be a laughing stock to the end of days. Yes. Quite strange, this place, my friend. Just a moment. Let me see if any of the others of our company are nearby. Just a moment. Gimli? Legolas? Samwise? Pippin? I believe we are lost. I'm pretty sure this confirms it. Smeagol? Gollum? Thorin? Dwalin? Balin? Fili? Kili? Pavor? Smog? Sauron? Is there anybody out there? Well, my friend, I do sincerely apologize for our peculiar and precarious predicament. I do like the sound of those words. Do you not? Peculiar. Sense strange magic at work here. I wonder where we are. Mirkwood? No. Moria? Khazad Dûm? Sorry that you followed me here. I thought that you and I would have a brief little chat about some very important matters at hand. We must have taken a wrong turn somewhere. Do you recall where we last were? I'm having a hard time trying to remember. Were we being chased by orcs? I do feel bit of a draft, somewhat cold. Do you feel the same, my friend? Yes. I do feel as though my magic, something subduing, nullifying my magic. I can feel it, but I believe I have just enough to create a little fire. Would you like that, my friend? Very good. Now, what was the spell again? It's been quite some time since I cast a fire spell. Ah, yes. tristeza, vindat con fila tonta. It worked. So very warm. Perhaps wallowy. While we figure out our predicament and how to get out of here. Perhaps we can enjoy a nice warm fire to keep the dark at bay. What do you think of that? A little light in the dark can never hurt, now can it? Ah, yes. A moment of quiet repose is in order. We have been on quite a many adventure, have we not? And I know at my age I could use a nice rest. What say you, my friend? Yes, you would like to take a moment here in this strange place to enjoy a nice rest? It's quiet. I do not hear the drums of the deep. We must not be in Moria. I do wonder where we are. Strange. Of all the places I've visited, traveled throughout all of Middle Earth, I do not believe I have ever been here. It feels different. Well, wherever we might be, hopefully our companions aren't too worried about us. If they know me as well as you, then surely they must know that I am one to suddenly depart from present company to attend to important matters. One moment we are together, and the next disappeared. I don't ever mean to do that intentionally and leave you or the others. Any great peril, but as I am sure you know, I was not sent here to meddle in the affairs of men or elves. Dwarves, or hobbits, even. But I am more of a guide to help nudge along. An idea. I believe this will be a good one this time. Why don't we take a look at, hopefully you have your sword with you. Perhaps it might show us if there is any evil about. Might I take a look at your sword? Very good. I'll put my staff aside. By the way, I hope you are not too worried. How would you like to listen to the sound of my staff? Plenty of some of the most renowned elves and men have enjoyed the sound of my staff, my very long staff. See his rune mark. And at the top, where the roots twist and become gnarled, rested his blue crystal. Source of his magic, I believe. I do not know for certain. And in place of his crystal, I have made a home. It, but tobacco. But, yes. So I have made a nice home for it, for my favorite smoking pipe, right in where the crystal used to be. Maybe it's a good thing I don't have any tobacco on me. I have considered giving up smoking quite some time. Quite a nasty little habit. Anyway, perhaps you might like, enjoy this sound. thing that I have to show you is right here. This nail that I use to carve symbols and runes to mark where I have been. Such as the rune that I magically marked on Bilbo. Staff, but because of the nature of this place that we are in, I am unable to use my staff to create any sorts of magic. Well, let me put this aside. Let us take a look at your sword. Actually, my friend, would you mind holding my staff for a moment so that I might look at your sword? Very well, thank you kindly. Excellent, my friend. Now, just take a look at your sword. Ah, yes. Sting. I believe it is called. Am I correct? Seems as though I can remember some things. Thank you. not glowing, which is good for us. As you know, if this blade were to glow, have a shimmering blue aura to it, then we would know there are orcs, goblins about. Any number of evil creatures created by Sauron, no doubt. Truly a remarkable blade. Familiar with the writing, the language written on the blade and on the hilt? Translate for you. Megnas ein estar nin dagnir in yngil im. Allow me to repeat that once again. Megnas ein estar nin dagnir in yngil im. Sting is my name. I am the spider's bane. Bilbo must have had that carved into the blade many years after his adventure. Just look how it catches flames of the fire. Do you know the story of how Bilbo came upon this sword? It is an elven sword made long ago in the kingdom of Gondolin. enemy is nearby, or one of Sauron's creations, perhaps is the better word. The language of the runes, the lettering, is Sindarin, language of the elves. But the story goes that Bilbo and his company as the trolls began to argue about how to cook the dwarves and the hobbit, how to eat them, prepare them, who to eat first. It's around that time that I had returned. I had a pressing matter to attend to. As I mentioned earlier, I have a bad habit of going off and leaving everyone and them not knowing where I went. But anyway, so as I returned and found my friends in quite a peculiar and precarious, perilous predicament, peculiar, precarious, perilous. as I came upon them as I returned to camp, found the footprints and the trail that led me to the troll camp. I heard the arguing. Well, I decided to perform a simple little bit of magic, quite rudimentary. I mimicked the voices of the trolls and made them argue and argue for hours. For you see, no match for the trolls myself, and I know their weakness. Daylight, sunlight, and so, as I mimicked Tom the troll, his voice, Bert's voice, and William's voice, and had those simple-minded trolls argue until the break of dawn. And that is when the sun rose, unbeknownst to them. And in an instant, before they even knew it, they were turned to stone. Not all precarious predicaments require powerful magic. And so, as I freed Bilbo and the dwarves from their bindings, we set about exploring the troll camp, and then we found a cave, troll cave to be exact, where trolls like to sleep, hide out of the daylight and keep their treasures. And while most of what we found in the cave was some gold coins and simple little treasures like that, chalices, we found three particular elvish swords. One was named Orcrist. Thorin took that one. Sword we found was called Glamdring. I took that one for myself, and I have it with me by my side. I'll show you that in a moment and go over the story of that one as well. And the third and final elven blade that was discovered in that troll cave was none other than this one. It did not have any runes or writing carved discovered this blade. Of course, when all three blades were found, there were no goblins or orcs nearby, so we were unaware of their power to glow and shimmer with light. But this is the blade that Bilbo found. And it wasn't until the company was captured once again, Bilbo and those dwarves sure found themselves in quite the pickle. The precarious, perilous pickle. Quite often being captured by trolls, being captured by spiders. Eventually name it, call it. I do not know why he would have the name written in Sindarin, but perhaps out of respect for the elves and the elvish nature of this blade. So that, my friend, is the story of Sting. And many times has it helped Bilbo, and even Frodo and Samwise on their journey. And then, of course, it was entrusted to you, either temporarily, I don't know, but that is for you to know. I do not need to know everyone's business. Yes. Hopefully, it will serve you well, protect you times of need. Okay, I'll give this back to you, my friend. And now, my friend, allow me to share with you the story of It also has elvish runes written upon it. Say, Turgon, Aron, Gondolin, Tortha, Gar, Amatha. Turgon, King of Gondolin, wields, has, and holds. And those were the runes, the carvings, written into the sword as I found it. And I almost forgot. There are runes written upon the other side, and they say, I, Vigil Glamdring, good Daedaloth, dumb on Glamhoth. The sword Glamdring, foe of Morgoth's realm, hammer to the orcs. This sword has aided me on many adventures of my own. I slayed a great goblin in Goblin Town. I do forget its name. When I fought a Balrog on the bridge, Khazad Dûm. But this sword has been by my side ever since I discovered it in that troll cave. Perhaps it was fate that we found all of those swords. Does not make as a relaxing sound isn't always a good thing, but it depends upon how you look at it. Friend, I must ask you, do you have it? And by it, I mean the one ring. You do. Might I take a quick look at it? Wonderful. Oh no. You don't have to worry. I'm not going to do anything with it. I have no such desire. I shouldn't even be asking to see it, but I just want to make sure it is in the right hands. Wonderful. Ah, you have it. Wrapped around your neck on a chain. Very good. I'll take that. Ah, yes. The one ring. Most sought after piece of jewelry, the most sought after item. You know the language written and the words written on this ring are in black speech. The language Mordor, created by Sauron. Did you know that the ring will change shape to fit any finger of whoever currently possesses it? So no matter if you are man, elf, hobbit, troll, perhaps even a dragon, it will fit on your finger. Shouldn't, but allow me to demonstrate. I know this goes against everything that I stand for, but I believe my will, strong, cannot be corrupted. Now you see me. Now you don't. Well, this is quite fun. I can feel its power trying to gain hold of me. I am Gandalf. I cannot be corrupted. And there, you see, I can remove it, put it back on, remove it, put it back on. I must say, it is quite, I'm quite taking a liking to it. I can still see the darkness, but in the distance, very faint movements of nameless things scurrying about. In the dark, no, I'm just joking. I don't see anything, but as you can see, the ring's power to corrupt has no effect on me. before I give the ring back to you, allow me to translate and read for you the inscription. So the story of this ring is that long ago, Sauron, a fallen Maya Ishtar like myself, came to Middle Earth with a plan. Certain number of rings to each of the races of men, elves, and dwarves. I do not recall the exact number. 3 rings to the elven king. Unbeknownst to those who wielded the 19 other rings, each ring was an extension of Sauron's will, and it granted him the ability from afar to control the wearer of those 19 other rings, to corrupt them, to basically do Sauron's bidding in a roundabout sort of way. I believe there were 6 or 9 of the men of the kings of men became so corrupt that they were turned into ringwraiths, Nazgul, and they would later join Sauron as his top generals. One of them, I believe, became the Witch King. But eventually, the forces of men and elves and dwarves joined together to fight Sauron. And one particular individual by the name of Isildur, the king of men, I believe, was able to cut off the finger of Sauron, which was wearing the One Ring. And this was long ago, many ages ago. And then Sauron began to crawl back into the shadows with his power fading over time. Isildur would come to wear and claim the One Ring for his own. But he too would become corrupted by the ring and eventually killed in an ambush one day, where the ring fell out of his possession. I do not know exactly how, and fell into the river Anduin, where it remained for thousands of years, I believe. And then, one day, a particular hobbit was fishing in the river and happened to notice or find the ring, and he claimed it for himself, even killing one of his own friends, I believe is how the story goes. And as he continued to possess the ring, wearing it on occasion, he too became corrupted by it. Eventually, he would leave the open air of Middle Earth and find refuge, find a new home on a small island in the middle of a subterranean lake beneath the mountains, not far from Goblin Town. And there, Gollum grew grotesque, completely corrupted by the ring. And there he remained for years, feeding on fish in the lake, or any unfortunate goblins traveling to and fro from Goblin Town. That would happen to get too close to Gollum's home. And then one day, it was Bilbo who would stumble upon Gollum's home, and Bilbo would find the ring, escaping from Gollum's lair through a game of riddles, tricking Gollum to reveal the exit by slipping on the ring and following Gollum. And from there on, Gollum knew that Bilbo, nasty hobbitses, stole his precious. And so Gollum would follow Bilbo and eventually Frodo in their attempt to destroy the ring. And that is the brief story of it. But yes, such a powerful and evil ring must be destroyed. I will give that back to you, since you have become its latest or current entrusted guardian. I can only assume that Bilbo or Frodo entrusted it to you, and well, who am I to judge? If they trust you with it, so be it. Unless you stole it from them. No, you wouldn't do such a thing. Well, I have held on to it long enough. I do feel a slight tug by the ring, and I wish to hold on to it longer, but I must not. Here you go, my friend. You may have the ring back. Just one more moment, if you... Yes, my precious. It's mine. It's ours, it is. Gandalf's precious. Oh, sorry. Yes, here, quickly, take it from me. Who knows what might happen should its power fully corrupt me? Do not think it would be possible, but... Well, my friend, I do not know how we will be getting out of this place, but I'm getting tired. I believe you are as well. What say you? I share a few stories, and we can both drift off to sleep. Would you like that? And then, when we wake from our rest, we can go about trying to find our way out of here. Okay, my friend. Very good. Before I bore you with my stories, how would you like to listen? Sound of my hat. is made of the finest quality. Did I have it made in Dale? Or was it Bree? I cannot remember. It does not matter. Let the sound of my hat help you to sleep or relax. Take a still stool. Now, my friend, if you would be so kind, I would like to take my staff back at this time. Wonderful. Now, what stories should I recount for you? There was a time once when I saved a great eagle from a poisoned wound that it suffered, and after that we became friends. And later, on a few occasions, that eagle would come to the rescue of myself and the company of Bilbo and the dwarves and others as well. save us from certain perilous predicaments. I believe I told you the story of Glamdring and the Balrog. Yes, I broke the bridge of Khazad-dûm. Well, the bridge leading out to the east gate, I believe, of Moria. Khazad-dûm, I shouted, "You shall not pass," and then I broke the bridge with my staff, slamming it down, and the Balrog lashed out with a whip. Pulled me down with it.